हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फाइल हैंडलिंग इन C++। इन दिस वीडियो सेशन आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंपैरिजन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फाइल्स। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स, कीप द बेल रिंगिंग because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos from my channel. Now let's move to the content. First of all, we'll see briefly what are different types of file with which we can access the records. So basically there are three types. They are sequential access files, index sequential access files, and direct access, or it is also called as random access files. What are these different files? I have already explained in separate videos. For the same, for your reference, I am providing a shortcut link for the playlist of types of files in C++ in this right up corner. Please go through that, because the prerequisite for this session is you must know the concept of all these files. Now I'll start the main part where I am trying to explain you the comparison from all these files. So I am comparing all these files with respect to these different concepts or with respect to these different topics. So here I am covering the comparison with respect to concept or the properties of the files, the uses of the files, where the files can be used, then the advantages of the files as well as disadvantages of all the files. So let's start with the concept and the properties of the files. So here I am explaining you all the three types of files. So let's start. First column is for sequential files, second is for index sequential files, and third one is for the direct or random access files. The names are different, but the things are under both the files are same. So let's start with the comparison. In sequential access file, the files, the implementation is very simple, and this is the method which is commonly used. But with respect to index sequential files, the implementation is moderate, not as very simple or not very difficult or complex. It is moderate, and mostly it is similar to sequential access file because only the difference is of the index. Here in random or indirect access file, the implementation is somehow complex with respect to sequential file or the index sequential file. Why it is complex? Because here we need to calculate somehow the address locations of every record. All these things are explained in detail in the respective videos. The next point for the comparison is how to access the information or the records. So here name itself suggests that all the records are accessed in the sequence or in a order from first to last. In the sequential access file, I am specifically explaining. In the index sequential file, the information or the records are accessed with the help of index, because this is the index sequential file. It is accessed sequentially but with the help of index. And in the last, for direct or random access file, any record, any information can be accessed directly or randomly. How this is happening? So the next point is for the same. Here as all the records are accessed sequentially, that's why the processing speed is very slow. In the index sequential file, it's more faster than that of the sequential file because it is accessed with the help of index. Index is useful while accessing the records, and that's why this is the index sequential file is faster than that of the sequential file. But the direct access file or random access file is very fast, or the fast method for the accessing all the records, because the addresses are calculated by applying a mathematical function. It goes directly or randomly to particular record which we want to access for any of the operation. So that's why here the random access files are complex. The information can be accessed directly or randomly with the help of address calculated by the mathematical function. So here briefly I am explaining you all the things by different files. That is, for a sequential access file, it is very simple and common method. All the records are accessed in the sequence, and all the records are accessed. That's why this process is very slow, or this file is slow. With respect to index sequential file, it is moderate, not as very simple or not as of very complex, but it is moderate and mostly similar to the sequential access file. The extra field is index, and that's why the information is accessed with the help of index, and it is more faster than that of the sequential file because all the records are accessed with the help of index. And I have already explained the direct or random access files. Let's move to the next comparison point, which is nothing but the uses of files, where the files can be used. Now all of us are knowing the properties of all these three files. With the help of that properties, here I am going to explain you where the files can be used. Now first of all, if it is sequential files, we need to access, or we can access all the records one by one in the sequence. So whenever I want to access all the records of my database or of my file, then the sequential access file is very useful. If I want to access some selective records only, and if I am available with the index in the index sequential file, then the index sequential files are very useful. And the last one, if I want to access any particular record where addresses are known, in that case I can use the direct or random access files. So in short, I would like to explain it again. Please listen carefully. Where I want to access all the records, then I will prefer to use a sequential file. If I want to access selective records and I am available with the index, then I will prefer the index sequential file. And if I want to access a particular record where the address can be calculated with the help of mathematical formula, then I will prefer to use the direct or random access files. Here I am trying to explain all the concepts with the help of examples. Like, if I want to update the payroll at the end of the month for any of the organization, so here I want to access all the records, that is all the employees from that organization. In that case, I will prefer to use the sequential file. If I want to send the bill or the statement to all my customers, here again all customers I need to access, so that's why I will use the sequential file. The next examples are for the index sequential file. That is, if I want to change the address location of any of the entity or a record, that I can search with the help of index. Then I will prefer the index sequential file because selective record I need to update. In the same way, if I want to update any roll number of a student with the help of index, then again I will prefer to use index sequential file. And at the last, when the addresses are known and I can access directly that particular record, in that case direct or random access files are very useful. So whenever we are going to access the CD or DVD content, in that case the addresses are already available and we can access it directly or randomly, any of the file, any of the folder. In the same way, this direct access file or random access file is very helpful for the database handling. Let's move forward for the next comparison point, which is nothing but the advantages. Here also I am trying to explain the comparison with respect to advantages for all these three types of files. The first comparison point is with respect to the implementation, the sequential files are very simple and commonly used. Here, index sequential files, somehow it is complex than that of the sequential files, but it provides the flexibility to user with respect to the use or the access of the records. And at the end, for the direct or random access file, any record can be accessed randomly, but somehow it is complex for the implementation. This is actually disadvantages. I am going to explain you the advantage, that's why please look forward for the advantage only. Like, any record can be accessed randomly or directly. The next point is the speed. This is very efficient when I want to access all the records. The speed of the index sequential file is faster than that of the sequential file, and the speed of the direct or random access file is very fast because it accesses any of the record directly. Let's move forward. For the next point of the comparison is nothing but the disadvantage of the files. So here I am explaining you the disadvantages for all the three types of files, where if I want to access a single record, then I need to access all the records probably from the sequential access file, and that's why the processing is very slow. With respect to index sequential file, disadvantage is if I want to store the index, because without index this index sequential file cannot work. So that's why to store that index it requires some extra space. And for the direct or random access file, as I explained previously, that it is somehow complex than that of the sequential or the index sequential access, because we need to maintain the addresses of the all the records. And as it does not utilize full memory, because the memory is provided to all the records, the memory is allotted all the record to all the records, and accordingly the address calculated, the records will get stored at that particular address location. So it may happen that the memory space is not utilized wisely. There may be the wastage of memory. So dear friends, I hope you are able to understand all the comparison points for all the three types of files. And thank you for listening and watching my video. If you like the content, please like my video and do not forget to give the comment. Here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks, along with I am providing you the shortcut link for new videos of my channel, as well as the playlist for the same video series, that is file handling in C++. Thank you friends, stay tuned with Tech Talks. Thank you.